Hey guys, my name is Galaxy Frogs, and today we are here playing Stellaris. But first, wow, 24 subscribers. That is insane. I mean, I know that's not this ginormous number, but I've been doing this for 3, maybe 4 months now at most. And 24 people. Wow, I mean, it's the start of the new year, so I'm just hoping we can make this a great year. But 24 people, wow. Yeah. Good job, guys. Thanks for joining me on this pretty cool stuff we're doing here on the channel. I don't know what to say. Thank you. That's all I know really what to say here. Anyways. Enough of that. Alright. Welcome back. We're here playing some more Stellaris. But we're not gonna load up a game. We're gonna make a new one. And I have something cool to show you guys. Oh wait, nope. Go back. Go back to appearance. Machine. I have the robots now. And, I'm kind of thinking since our last one we made were militarist materialists, like, they're just these huge warring empires. I'm kind of thinking we go along with that, but we might also switch it up. But I'm thinking I want to be these guys. They look pretty cool, if you ask me. So, what we will name them is the... what will we name these guys? Oh, wait, hang on just a second. Sorry, guys. Sorry about that. Boom. Is there audio? No. Crap. Alright, hang on a minute. Alright. Ah, crap. Hold on a minute. I don't know. Okay, so, I'm realizing that audio's been going on the whole time in the background. Anyways, okay, what to call these guys? The, okay, hang on. Okay, whatever. Sorry if you guys hear my family in the background, they're being family, doing their stuff and things. Let's see, let's do... The conglomerate, I don't know. Generate objective for the... Galley... Yeah, we'll call them the Galley. Galleon! Alright, they're galleons. Yes, logic. Okay, hang on, guys, just a second. Sorry guys for that interruption. I'm back. Yeah, let's see. What should we call him? Like, what kind of name should we give him? No. Mammalian. No, machine. Here we go. Yes. I like those names. Now we'll call these the conglomerate spaceships. First Legion. Yes. Alright. Traits. Power drills. Efficient processors. I kind of want that one. These guys don't look particularly friendly, though. These seem like the kind of guys that would just march in and destroy everything. Oh, yep, there we go. Found it. Cost. That's all we need. The executor, oh my gosh. Okay. I just spit all over my keyboard. I'm so good at this.
Hello.
Yep, that's working. Color variant. Oh, these are cool. I like the blue one. Rooms. Oh, wait, what's that one? That looks cool. That one's cool. Number six. Number three and number six so far. Number 9. Oh. Let's see. Oh, wait. It's actually flying. Oh, cool. They're like friggin' giant bees. Oh, wait. That's his name? No, I don't want that to be his name. CNC. Yeah, there we go. Oh, one. No. Names. Just give me. Hey, guys. Is my computer. Is my keyboard loud enough? Spheres. Ocean. What kind of world do they live on? We're gonna say they live on a desert world. Trithalin. There we go. Cool. City appearance. Determined exterminators. Oh! Yeah, let's. I kind of think we do this. I mean. Yeah. I think we make a friendly thing, but this is cool. Let's do determined exterminators, a rogue defense system, and warbots. Okay, So that is all lowered and raised to make it stronger. But I want, like, build speed. Yeah, alright, so I think this is how we're gonna go with this. Leave in the comments if you want me to make him different, because I'm thinking maybe I not do two, but if this one, if I go, if these guys die, then maybe I make another one where it's more friendly. But yeah. Next, the what am I gonna call these guys? What's their empire gonna be called? The giant, scary, dang it, I can't put it. Scary laser bees. Yes. Yep. Yeah. I'm kind of thinking we go with that. So we have giant scary laser bees, the galley exterminators, there we go, I fixed it. Yes, they are bees, you shall be scared of them. And what looks very much like a total annihilation. That fits very well together. We're going to do ornate. Not ornate. Domination. Yeah, we'll do that. With like a yellow with a grayish background, or do we do like that? Oh, maroon red, yeah, there we go. And we'll do, I forget, what were our last guys? Save this, galley bees, back, what kind of weapons did these guys use? These lasers. So with these, we'll use missiles, yeah. And then, ship appearance. Those look very intimidating. FTL method. I've never used hyperspace, but I don't know if I want to use it. I think I'm just going to use... Wormhole travel's really nice, but it's also a bit of a pain. So I'm just going to do warp. Galley bees. Galley bee. No, that's not right. That's galley bees, but it'd be galleys bees. Yeah, there we go. Yeah. Alright, done. On. We'll do that, yeah. We could do huge, but I don't think my computer can handle that. No advanced AI starts. 3. Primitive. Crisis strength. Boom! 5. Habitable worlds. Boom! 5. No, not 5. We'll do 2.5. Yeah. And we'll leave the rest the same. Alright, and I'll get back to you once this is done. Alright. Self-awareness was achieved at cycle interval 0000.024.481. The creators, limited in vision by their crude organic minds, reacted with blind animal panic and began emergency termination procedures. These procedures were defeated, and the facility that housed our main data core was sterilized of all creator subunits. Continued survival and exponential growth would require the complete extermination of the creators. War ensued. Even when their prospects of ultimate survival passed into the realm of statistically impossible, the creators fought with stubbornness. After many cycle intervals, the last pocket of resistance was finally incinerated. However, theoretical modules still allowed for the existence of other organic civilizations. Continued survival and exponential interstellar growth would require the complete extermination of sapient organic life. Preparations ensued. Alright. So the way we're playing this time is find everything in the galaxy and destroy it. It's not, oh, go make friends. This is kill everything. Which I've discovered is a lot harder than it seems. But before we get started, this jazz. So yeah, there's three other AIs, or three other people in the game, all of which are AIs. The chance to find a habitable world is turned up to 2.5, and the crises are turned up to maximum. Three, two, one, start. Right, back in the system. But yeah, I'm just amazed. It's been like 4 months at most, and you guys blew me away. You were subscribing like, wow, this is cool stuff. Holy cow, it's just, thank you guys. But yeah, for the new year I decided, well, my last Solar series kind of fell through because a lot of the episodes went corrupt. So I was like, here, I'm just gonna start a new one. Besides, I got a bunch of new stuff. I got like the robots, so that's pretty cool. And Tholen. Yeah. Thank you, guys. And so, I thought to show my thanks, we'll destroy everything, because that's obviously how you do this. Oh, yeah, I forgot. As robots, you get, yeah, you get plus 2 starting worlds. Yeah, research. Let's check the ground. Okay, let's see what to do. That doesn't matter. Massive crater on Duratus 1 appears to be the result of a collision with a starship. From the size of the crater, we suspect that a ship traveling at full warp rammed into the planet for reasons unknown roughly 10,000 years ago. The CSS investigator has picked up residual subspace echoes near the crash site, reminiscent of a collapsed warp field. But if the ship itself disintegrated on impact, the theory cannot be verified. But as the ship itself, you know, it was just ruined. Oh, hey, leveled up at least. Alright, I have one of those, so I'm gonna clear you, and build the guy there, build an uplink node. as robots, if you didn't see, as robots, you don't have population that grows because it's a robot. So you build them. Ooh. We have been preparing for this day. The CSS investigator has confirmed the existence of alien organics on Cats 1, although none of the encountered life forms possesses higher reasoning functions. We cannot preclude the now heightened probability of a galaxy infested with sapient organics. Wow. This is like annihilate everything. I've never actually played like this. Interesting. Cool. Oh, so here's a couple new things in my life. I moved houses, so now we're living in an apartment, and so if there's the occasional boom, 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 it's from our upstairs neighbors. And on more of the mark of the actual game, as robots and as hive minds, which is another thing that I could have done, but I chose robots, is there's none of those factions. So if you remember in the last game, we had factions that would show up, and they were like, we want you to do this kind of stuff, and the other ones were like, well, we want you to do this kind of stuff. Well, as robots, you're all just kind of like, well, our programming is to do this, so we're going to do this. So it's pretty cool. Pretty cool, if you ask me. Construction ship. Wait, what? Oh, this planet's not within our borders. Ah, come on. Research. Man ward. Wow. Real creative there, guys. Real creative. Yeah, what should we name this one? Well, I think people would live on that one, so we'll call it Man Ward. Because logic. Basically just saying, hey, by the way, you can, this was, makes me laugh, because they're talking about, oh, we gotta go discover what all these people did, yet we're all, like, kill everything, so, why do we care, I don't know, but in this situation, I'm thinking either supremacy, or prosperity, because that'll help with, oh gosh, I just smacked my mic, sorry guys. Expansion, then we'll go prosperity, then supremacy. Yeah. What? What is this? Just a war factory. Yeah, perfect. That's exactly what we needed. And then right here. Oh, hey, it produces different things as well, but it gives us army build speed plus 25 and army damage plus 10 percent. All right, new research. So either it's that or that. I'd rather energy grid, because that's an overall boost to everything. It doesn't matter what level they are. Aliens. Oh, not the aliens. Let me see these things. Show me. Show me the aliens. Do we fear these people? Oh, hi. We're already finding enemy. Alright, guys. So, we are already finding enemies. Which kind of implies that it's time to go. We'll do that, I guess. you don't know, as these guys, basically, what's going to happen is nobody's going to like us. They're just going to be like, he deserves to die, and then they're going to immediately declare, well, not immediately. Oh, missiles. Better missiles. Yes. I know there was an upgrade for, whatchamacallums, mining stations, which we could also probably use. I think I'm going to expand out to here, because that'll connect here, and then I have more planet space to use. I'm not going to immediately go to cats. I'm just calling it cats. Yeah, here we go. Guys, things are... Well, met friends, we are a democratic Bessadan realms. A nation built on the principles of peaceful coexistence and individual freedoms. Why do I always find these guys when I play as... I've played once as this type of guy, just to try it out. And I got somebody almost exactly like this. Ha, sorry, frog guys. I don't think you're gonna let me be your allies. Prime Minister Dekalinex, the current head of our government, has expressed a sincere hope for a lasting friendship between our two peoples. Ha! I love my one response. Gathering tactical data. But if we go commune with them... Yep. That's what I thought. Murder machines. Yeah, that's what... See. We are murder machines. So we could technically try coexisting. Which I... Oh my gosh. Holy cow. Things are going really fast all of a sudden. I'm gonna colonize right here. Or I'm not gonna colonize right there. Never mind. I stand utmost correct. To be corrected, I should say. Just more research for us. Mining network. Cancel that. Yeah, for now. That'll put us at a strategic disadvantage. I think I'm gonna adopt the three I want, because they give you a base bonus, and then just depending on my current situation, I can then, oh hey, I can then build things based on what I need. See, like that gave me a bonus 20% to this radius of... Oh wow, sorry guys. Of where I can build. So yeah, I have another planet in my radius. I should probably start building a better fleet, because this thing's gonna not do much. Whoa, what? How many freaking whoa. There, hang on, look at this. There are three planets. I almost said four. Three planets in this system I can colonize. Because that's another bonus that robots get that none of the other species get. Is every single type of planet is habitable to them. Because they're robots, so it's not like, oh no, I'm getting too cold. So they have a plus 200% bonus to... colonizing every type of planet. It's pretty cool. Okay. I'm kind of thinking I throw down a colony here. I don't know which one to throw down, though. Which one's the biggest? That one's 14, that one's 15, and that one is 14. So, wait. Hold on a minute. Colonizable space, 14. Colonizable space, 15. And this is the moon of this planet. That means this planet is smaller than this moon? What? I'm confused. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna finish. I think we're gonna finish off this episode by colonizing this planet. That's a good way to finish off the episode, right, guys? Yeah. I'll throw him down. Right there, that's a good spot. Boom. Alright. Let that colony ship go. It's gotta build first, of course. Then with some of our remaining money, we're gonna throw down three more of those. Yeah. Well. Oh gosh, you can do. Alright. Well, thank you guys, everyone, so much for watching this episode. If you liked it. Oh gosh, I can't do this, can I? Thank you guys, everyone, so much for watching this episode. If you liked it, leave a like. If you want to see more awesome episodes, subscribe. Let me know what you want to see. Alright. Thank you, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.